Good morning and welcome back to White Mountains Today here at White Mountain TV 16. And joining us in the studio, Thomas Prindle is here from Attitash and Wildcat. And going to find out all the scoop.
Yeah.
All the scoop. And there's a lot of scoop. You got some big news, too.
Yeah, there's a lot for me to cover today, obviously, talking about Attitash Mountain
Resort
and Wildcat Mountain. You want me to just kind of take it away?
Go ahead.
Well, we've got some great conditions going on. I'm sure you guys have been talking about the incredible spring weather we're enjoying here.
Yes.
You know, winter has been sort of a challenge this season, but what we have open at this point is really good because of, thanks to the effort of our snowmakers the entire winter to really get our trails and terrain covered and open. And also our groomers have been working, you know, week to week to kind of recover from rain, thaw, freeze events. And once again, they've done a great job. This past week, we saw some wet and warm weather, and it sort of deteriorated the natural snow that we had. But where we've made snow all season is holding up really well. At my last check, I saw that Wildcat Mountain still has 19 trails, has 8 miles of terrain, you know, top to bottom skiing and riding up there at Wildcat Mountain.
Oh, yeah.
So really good terrain. And then Attitash has over 80% of their trails and terrain open, and 206 acres, 17 miles of skiing and riding there. So although we've lost some of the trails, just keep in mind that our lift ticket combined at both Wildcat and Attitash, you really got a significant amount of acres and trails and miles to be enjoying. So.
And the great thing, too, is that, you know, and the proximity of the two mountains, ski one in the morning, have lunch, ski one in the afternoon.
You're absolutely right. I mean, I've done it many, many times, and it's literally only 20 minutes from parking lot to parking lot. So just like you said, I mean, you can start your day at one mountain and finish up at the other and really be enjoying a variety of available trails and terrain and skiing and riding. And yesterday was just an absolutely gorgeous day. As we know, with spring conditions, really conditions only start to get better as the day goes on, as temperatures start to warm up and the sun rises. If it feels a little firm in the morning, wait it out, maybe go have a little breakfast, come back out as things start to soften up, and it starts to get really good.
So, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, you've also got a good deal, season pass deal going on now.
Yeah.
Awesome season pass.
Yeah, why don't we, if you don't mind, I'd like to talk about that a little later. I want to talk about some events going on.
All right, you do that.
Yeah.
You do what you want.
Yeah,
Thomas.
We've got
I'm just hanging out.
Some great events going on at Attitash Mountain Resort. I want to mention today we have the Sean Smith Ski for Youth fundraiser event going on. Tom Eastman did a great story in Friday's edition talking about this being a benefit for Ben Damon. They're trying to raise some money to afford him a bus. He was injured in a auto accident with a moose.
Yep.
And he's recovering from that. So that's going on today, and registration is from 8 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. The cost to register for the event is $20. But it's a great fundraising event. I know there's going to be a lot of locals out there participating in that event today. Corey Madden's going to be setting up the race on Spillway. So it's going to be a real, real fun day. They're going to have live music after the event, and it should be a great day.
Nice.
Also want to mention coming up on the radar, I know a lot of people are very excited for the upcoming Red Parka Pub Challenge Cup. This is a huge event. I think it's one of the longest running pro-style dual course with the bump race events in the U.S.
Yeah,
and a lot of upper talented racers come out from various parts of the region, college racers, ex-pro racers. It's a really, really fun event. So the Red Parka Pub Challenge Cup, that's coming up this Friday, March 18th. You can check out the Red Parka Pub website. We'll have information on that.
Yep.
And I think they still have registration open.
I think they do. I think I saw that. Yeah.
Have you ever been to that event?
I have. I actually announced that event one
year. Did you?
So, and it's great. It's so exciting.
You know, it's fun for the participants in the races, and it's a lot of fun for those who are watching.
For the crowd, events. Absolutely.
You know, if we get some great weather, people kind of congregate towards the bump, and it's just a party atmosphere going on there. So, and then next Saturday, we finish up our You Go Girl race series. You Go Girl race series, which is not just open to female girls, women. It is open to the male boys, men's. To participate in this fundraising event that's assisting Jen's friends here in the Mount Washington Valley, assisting those who are fighting cancer with their everyday expenditures. So another great event, and that's going to be next Saturday, March 19th. I do want to mention, yesterday we had our Attitash Snow Stage. We had outdoor live music, and we had this band called Riot Act, and it was just unbelievable. Absolutely gorgeous day. You know, last winter we were not able to use the outside snow stage. There's a great shot of the crowd that was there rocking out to Riot Act. And we're going to be doing the outside snow stage for the remainder of every weekend.
Great.
As Attitash Mountain Resort remains open as we are planned to stay open through the first weekend in April. So we got a lot of great live music. Next Saturday, it's Ovation, a great 80s rock band. So people should be coming dressed for their 80s. Maybe sporting their mullet wigs and their best 80s.
Or their mullets.
Or their actual mullets.
If they want.
Yeah, exactly. Start growing it now. So Ovation next Saturday. And then we have Jonathan Sardi, who, if it's nice weather, he'll be playing outside of Bear Peak Base Lodge. So there's a lot going on there. And then for events up at Wildcat Mountain, I want to talk a little bit about tomorrow. We're having the annual 100,000 Vertical Foot Challenge to benefit Make-A-Wish New Hampshire. This is the 13th annual event going on up there. This event, since it began 13 years ago, has raised over $750,000 directly benefiting Make-A-Wish New Hampshire.
That's awesome.
It's a huge, huge event. And this year's participants, at my last check, had already raised online over $52,000 for that event. So it's a limited field of participants looking to ski over 100,000 vertical feet in one day. The reason I want to mention this is because if there's any sort of regular midweek Monday skiers, we do close the Lynx Trail up at Wildcat Mountain for the participants as they attempt to ski at least 48 runs. So it's one of those things that I want to extend my appreciation and thanks to those skiers and riders who normally might be up there. We will be closing the Lynx Trail for the event tomorrow.
But it's for a good cause.
It's for an incredible cause. I think they equate about $10,000 per wish for children. So, I mean, if you think about that we've afforded 75 wishes already, and it looks to be at least 5 additional wishes to be raised by tomorrow. And I expect there's going to be a lot more money coming in tomorrow morning. So, anyways, but just a reminder, links will be closed. But nonetheless, your lift ticket, season pass, it is valid at Attitash Mountain Resort, too. So, no worries. You can be skiing and riding all day. Also, I want to mention next Saturday, Ability Plus, which is the local adaptive Mount Washington Valley chapter based out of Attitash that affords adaptive programs at Attitash and Wildcats, doing a fundraising event up at Wildcat Mountain on Saturday, March 19th. So this is one of their bigger fundraising events. So check that out. There's information at Attitash.com. You can link to the Ability Plus page to get all the information on that. And then as well, Wildcat Mountain's starting to have their, if it's very nice weather, they'll have music outside on the deck.
Which is a great spot for that.
It is a great spot. I know Chris Prue was up at Wildcat yesterday enjoying the beautiful weather and scenery. Right, Chris?
Getting that thumbs up from Chris.
Yeah, getting the thumbs up from the studio. There's a lot going on there. Also want to mention upcoming this week, we have some great ticket deals. We have St. Patrick's Day, of course, Thursday. We're going to be offering $17 lift tickets at both Attitash and Wildcats. So definitely take advantage of that if you can. That discount will be available right at the window, so it's not a pre-purchase type thing. And then also next Sunday, we have Youth Pay Their Age. Ages 18 and under will just pay their age on Sunday, March 20th. So some really great ticket deals. Also, every Friday in March is $40 Friday. That is an e-ticket discount, though.
Right, you got to get that ahead of time.
That needs to be pre-purchased at least 24 hours or at least the night before you plan on skiing on the Friday. So check out. We do have e-tickets every day. Check those out. Now I can come back to the peak pass. The new peak pass. I know you guys are running a promotion for that as we sponsor the weather graphics, but the new peak pass is Peak Resort's newest Northeast pass. It's an incredible deal, not only for low prices, but the pass now includes all 7 Northeast Peak Resort ski areas.
That's awesome.
So that's Attitash, that's Wildcat, that's Crotchet Mountain in southern New Hampshire, that's Mount Snow in Vermont, which also is home to the Carinthia Terrain Parks, voted number one terrain parks by Free Skier Magazine. Also includes newly acquired Hunter Mountain in New York, as well as Jack Frost and Big Boulder, which is considered 2 mountains.
Yeah.
So we say 7 mountains on one pass. Jack Frost and Big Boulder are the 2 mountains in Pennsylvania. But the price right now at the early rate for an adult, no blackout dates, is only $599.
That's amazing.
Which is actually cheaper than what we were selling our Granite Pass last year at. So we have, and the prices go down from there. We have $399 for youth, age 7 to 17, mm-hmm. For the what is called the Explorer Pass, part of the Peak Pass. And all this information is available at peakpass.com. We also have an incredibly low-priced midweek pass. We have a low-priced drifter pass for ages 18 to 29. It's kind of like a college pass, but you don't have to be in college to get the low rate. And other things that also new this year is that we introduced a new payment plan. So right now, people can buy the new Peak Pass at the early rate with a $99 down payment. And then that would spread out the payments for the following 4 months, I believe, successively after this month. But the good thing is that you can put your down payment on a new Peak Pass and start skiing or riding today on your new pass for next season.
That's a nice little bonus right there.
It is a great bonus, and there's also additional benefits associated with being a pass holder, ticket discounts, retail discounts, all types of discounts associated with a new pass. So this is a really exciting pass. I think it's probably one of the lowest price passes for the most mountains in the Northeast. So peakpass.com is where to check out all the new passes.
Well, that's really cool.
It is cool, Rob. Yes. Thank you. Thank you to punctuate that.
There you go. It's really cool. So, now, that's great. And then I had read just recently that you had acquired, or Peak had acquired, Hunter Mountain.
Yes.
So gives a broad swath, I guess.
Have you been there to Hunter Mountain? Or
I'm trying to remember if I've been to Hunter Mountain. I was going to Hunter Mountain back in 1984, but the weather did not cooperate, so we didn't go. So now I'm trying to remember if I ever skied. I skied at Hunter.
Did you?
Yeah.
I've never been there, so I can't.
I remember, it's a big mountain.
Yep.
And a nice mountain. My wife did her internship there, so she skied there all the time. So she was taking me to learn how to ski at Hunter Mountain.
Nice.
So now I can't. I think I did ski there.
It's all fuzzy back then.
Right? It is, back in the 80s. We don't remember much. So that would have been 32 years ago that I would have skied at Hunter Mountain. But
Very nice.
So,
everything that I talked about, I know it was a lot. You can check it out at Attitash.com and SkiWildcat.com. You can also visit our snow report to see the most current conditions. People keep asking me, when are you open through?
Yeah.
And really, the game plan right now, and until I'm told otherwise, is Attitash will remain open through the first weekend in April. And Wildcat Mountain would continue to operate past that as late as they can. But again, weather and conditions are going to dictate any sort of changes to that. But certainly, Attitash.com and SkiWildcat.com is where we post the most current information first.
But at the very least, we know we're skiing for a while.
Yeah. I mean, it looks like we're skiing for a while. I was skiing yesterday. It was incredible. And like I said, where we've made snow and where groomers can continue to get to is holding up really well.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Well, Thomas, thanks so much for coming by.
Thank you, Rob.
And I'm sorry I had to try to pull the information out of you like that. And
no, I had a game plan.
So definitely check out the websites, do some skiing, and we'll be back here in a minute on White Mountains Today.